Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I have some very easy to do Dollar Tree fall DIYs. So let's go ahead and get started on our first project. Using this double-sided wood truck from Dollar Tree, once I remove that tag, I'm going to pull these apart, and they're very easy to pull apart. Just take your time and be careful, and that way you won't rip the back of them. I'm also going to go ahead and remove those wooden blocks on there and take a piece of sandpaper and sand that down nice and smooth because we will be painting both sides. Using Waverly White chalk paint, I'm going to paint the truck, the front and the back, except for the back part of those slats, like they go over top of the truck bed, as well as the wheels. So again, I'm going to paint them on both sides because you will be able to see that. Once that dries, I just took a pencil and kind of drew in where the wheels would be so that I would have a guide to go by to use my black chalkboard craft paint. And I again am going to paint that on the front and the back. Just because the way we're creating this project, you could possibly see both sides. I'll do that for both of the trucks, and I also made sure that I got down in those rims and those outside edges. For the back of the truck, those slats on the back, I'm going to use some Waverly Antique Wax, and I'm just going to apply that with a regular soft paintbrush, again on the front and the back, and I did that for both trucks. Using four of these brain teaser game pieces that you can pick up from Dollar Tree, I'm going to glue two of those together, and I'm trying to make sure that those holes are not visible on the sides or the top. And then I went over it with some of the antique wax just to kind of make sure that it matched the back of the truck. This is a piece of fabric that I purchased from Dollar Tree last year, and this is just a small scrap piece. So I'm going to cut that down into a square so that I can place this on the door. And I wanted to be able to see that mirror that's right there on the side. So I just cut a little semicircle out so that you will be able to see that side mirror. And also trimmed up the bottom so that you would be able to see where the stair rail is on the truck. Once I have that all cut out, and again, I'm going to cut that for both of the trucks, and I'm only going to place this on the outsides of the trucks. I don't put it on the inside. To apply this, I'm going to use some Mod Podge and just put a nice even layer on there and press that down, and then I will go back over it with Mod Podge to seal that in. And again, I did that for both of the trucks. Now it's time to assemble this piece. And I wanted those brain teaser pieces to show through the center of the wheels. So I am carefully making sure that I line that up. I'm going to attach this using just some hot glue, but I do recommend that you use a little bit of E6000. I'm just using the hot glue for video purposes. Once I have the one side attached, I can then attach the other side and press that together. And now you have the cutest napkin holder. This is absolutely adorable. You could put any color napkins you want in there. I love how this little project turned out, and I hope you guys like it as well. Let me know what you think in the comments section down below. Now let's get started on our second project. Using two of these wood pumpkin signs from Dollar Tree, once I remove the bows and the tags, I tried to remove all that glue, and it was a little bit difficult to remove. I tried to sand it down so it discolored it a little bit, but that's okay because I'm going to paint it. And I also went back in with some hot glue to glue some of those end pieces down because they were popped up a little bit. Now here I'm showing you that I'm trying to very carefully paint just the outside portion with the Waverly White chalk paint, but I do recommend if you recreate this project to paint the whole piece. Go ahead and paint those wood pieces because the fabric that I'm using, you can see a hint of that wood behind it. So I did paint both of those on the back as well. Using that same buffalo check print fabric from Dollar Tree, I'm going to place some clamps to hold that in place all the way around the pumpkin so that I can take just a regular ink pen and trace around the raised portions of the pumpkin. And I'm going on the outside edge of it. So we're going to cut this off so you won't even see the ink marks at all. So I went around all three of those pieces, and then I can take my scissors and cut these down. And I'm actually going to go on the inside line where I drew so that you can cut the line off and you won't see that on your fabric. You could also use scrapbook paper instead of fabric, but this is what I had on hand and I loved the print on this. So once I have all those cut out and I know that they're going to fit on there properly, I'm just going to attach this using some Mod Podge and make sure that I press it firmly on all the edges and get any kind of wrinkles out and make sure it's nice and smooth. Now see, you can see here just a hint of that wood behind it, so I do recommend that you paint that as well, just because my fabric was so thin. And I did this for both signs. And I also went back over top of my fabric with the Mod Podge to seal it in to make sure that none of those edges fray. Using just one of the leaves off of this pumpkin filler from Dollar Tree, so I will attach one leaf to both of the pumpkins. I'm going to hot glue that down at the top and then use some jute rope to wrap around about half of the stem at the top. So I like to start on the back so that when I finish up, I can finish on the back and you don't see those cut pieces at the end. And it was just enough to cover the hole at the top, but gave it a nice little pop of color. Using this really beautiful burlap lace type ribbon from Dollar Tree, I'm going to create a very simple bow and tie that in the center with some jute string or jute rope. And then I can hot glue that right there at the top of the leaf. I thought this was so adorable. And again, I created both of them exactly the same. Taking some wood glue and two of the tumbling tower pieces, as well as some hot glue, I'm going to glue those end to end. And then those wood cubes that you can purchase from Dollar Tree, I am going to glue one on the top of each end on the flat side. So it's going to look a little bit like a bracket, and I'm going to create two of these. So they almost look like a bracket or a handle. And once I have those together, I am going to give those one good coat of my Waverly White chalk paint all the way around the entire piece. Now this is what we're going to use to attach our two pumpkins together. And if you haven't guessed already, we are going to be making a paper plate holder or a plate holder. So if you're going to put anything heavy in there, I do recommend you use some sort of E6000 in addition to this hot glue. I'm using the hot glue because one, for video purposes, but two, I'm just going to put paper plates in there. And I did make sure that I put them at the bottom of the pumpkin so you would not see those from the front or the back. And then once you attach these two pieces together, you have a very beautiful paper plate holder that goes very well with your napkin holder. So these would be really nice for a nice fall barbecue. So you guys, let me know what you think of project number two. Today's video is in collaboration with Kathy over at Crafty Kathy. I will leave a link to her video in my description box down below. She does a farmhouse, Dollar Tree DIYs, haul videos, cottagecore, thrift flips, so many things, and she's so talented. She also has the most amazing personality. I think you will truly enjoy her videos, so please go over, check her out, and give her some love, and let her know that I sent you. If you're coming over from Kathy's channel, or you're new to my channel, I would love for you to click that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you will be reminded the next time I upload a brand new video. Also, visit me on Instagram, my website for free printables, as well as my Pinterest board. Okay, you guys, let's get started on our third project. Using one of these really beautiful glass jars from Dollar Tree, once I remove the lid and that sticker from the bottom, I have made sure that it was nice and cleaned with some alcohol, and then I'm going to give this one coat of my Waverly White chalk paint. I am taking my time and making sure that I get it nice and smooth and down in between all of those crevices on the jar. Now, I do only give this one coat because I wanted it to have a hint of a rustic look, and I only painted the rim at the top right underneath where the lid screws on because I don't want to paint the part where the lid goes on. Now I did give the bottom two coats to make sure that was nice and covered. And once this dries, it just has a very beautiful look to it. Now I'm going to set that to the side and work on the lid. I liked the fact that the lid was silver, so I'm going to leave that color alone. And then I'm going to use one of these leaves off of the pumpkin filler from Dollar Tree, as well as one of these wood stems from Dollar Tree. Now, I had some of these left over from last year. I'm using some E6000 and hot glue to attach this to the center of the lid. And then I'm also going to hot glue that leaf right off to the side. And this is super cute just as it is, but to add a little something extra to it, I'm going to use one of these chalkboard signs and remove the back, and one of these white paint markers that I purchased from Dollar General. You can write whatever you want on there, but I thought it would be really cute to be able to store mints there. Like I said, if you're having some sort of fall barbecue or you're watching football games or whatever, after you eat, people can have a mint. So I'm taking some jute rope and I've hot glued that to the back of the chalkboard sign and then wrapped that around my stem a few times and then I just tied that off. Using some gingham ribbon from Dollar Tree, I'm going to create a very simple bow and tie the center with that jute rope. And then I can hot glue this right to the stem, but I do make sure that I dovetail those ends to give it just an added little extra detail. Now this is so cute. I love how this one turned out, and it looks really well with our previous two projects. And if you remove that fall leaf, you could use this year round. Okay, you guys, let's go ahead and get started on our fourth and final project for today. We are going to be starting off with one of these mini pillows from Dollar Tree. I was so excited to find this. I actually found about four different kinds. I am removing the seam at the bottom where the stuffing went in. Once I have that removed, I'm going to remove all of the stuffing from the pillow and then turn it inside out so that I can carefully cut those seams on the outside edges. I did make sure that I pulled all those corners out so I can get a nice square cut of fabric. I'm just going on the inside of the seam just to cut those seams out. And once I get to the side where the little rope was sewed on, I will open that up and cut that rope down just to kind of get it out of the way and to make sure that I get a nice straight cut. So now once I have all of those seams cut out, I have two really pretty pieces of fabric. And I just love the colors on these, and they're perfect for this glass jar from Dollar Tree. I'm going to remove the lid. I'm not going to use the lid in this DIY. Now, I did give this one base coat of my white chalk paint because that fabric is very thin, and I didn't want you to be able to see through it. So once that dries, I'm going to measure the top and bottom portion there of this glass jar to make sure that I cut my fabric down. So I did trim some off of the bottom as well as the top so I could get that really beautiful pumpkin centered on this jar. And I'm also going to cut just, you know, the same length on that back piece so that we'll be able to attach that to the jar as well. Using some Mod Podge again, I'm going to put a nice, generous, even coat on there and then lay my fabric out, smooth it down, get all those wrinkles out, make sure everything's nice and glued down. And it did go a little bit above the top rim and below the top rim, but I wanted it to do that because we are going to cover that up. I also went back over top of the entire piece of fabric with the Mod Podge. Now, don't do what I do. My little brown piece for the back is absolutely perfect to fit on this. It is a little bit larger, so I cut some off, but I ended up cutting too much off, and I'll show you how I fixed that. So my measurements were just a little bit off, but I'll show you guys what I did. So I evened it up. I laid it out very evenly where the first piece of fabric was and applied my Mod Podge and sealed that down. And now you can see that tiny little gap. You could leave it like that and it's okay, but I didn't like it, so I'm going to go back over that with a very tiny small strip and blend that in with my Mod Podge. Now let your Mod Podge completely dry before you move on to your next step. I'm going to take some jute rope and I'm going to wrap the bottom of this jar, and I'm starting on the back side. And for the very first part, I'm just periodically going in and adding some hot glue and just kind of keeping it lined up until I get all the way to the bottom of the jar. Now for the top, because you have that little twisted rim on the very first part, I can go all the way around. But when I get to those rims, I do add the glue to make sure that my rope will stay on top of those. And then I'll just go all the way to the top of the jar And this is the cutest utensil holder. You can use this for utensils or plasticware if you're having a cookout, or silverware. But I love how it turned out, and I think it's just really beautiful. You guys, let me know what you think of all of these projects. If you have a favorite, I think they look really gorgeous together. Again, I think this would be really beautiful for a nice fall get together. So if you have a favorite, let me know in the comment section down below. I always love to know which one is your favorite. Please go over and check out Kathy at Crafty Kathy. I will have a link of her video in my description. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate you. Please take care, and I will see you guys next time.